animal classification. When we look around, we come across tremendous diversity of life forms ranging from very tiny microorganisms which cannot be seen with our naked eyes to very complex organisms, human beings. Regardless of their complexity, in order to live, they perform all the functions on their own. If we want to understand the life around us, it's important to organize them to discuss their functions, characteristics, and similarities. Systems of classifying organisms have evolved over the years, and from the chart, you can see that scientists have divided the organisms into different kingdoms. Among these scientists, the Swedish botanist Carl Linnaeus is regarded as father of taxonomy, as he developed a system known as Linnaean taxonomy for categorizing organisms and binomial nomenclature for naming organisms. The scientists are still refining the system of classification of organisms. They are now relying on analyzing DNA of organisms. You have learned the conventional system of classification of animals into two groups, chordates and non-chordates. You have also seen how Whitaker classified animals into different classes based on different grades of organization. Does it become a bit difficult to remember all these labels and different names? Let's devise some tricks to remember the labels of classification. Let's pick up the first letter from each word and form an acronym. King, Philip, cries, out, for, good, sleep. Can you create a funny statement to remember all 10 phyla under non-chordates? Protozoa, Ascalmanthus, Cnidaria, Porifera, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, Hemichordata. You can also try arranging the letters, which will be easy for you to remember.